Hey, this is DJ from DJ's Trains on YouTube, and this video is about the Carrie furnaces. There was once 7 blast furnaces that made up Andrew Carnegie's steelmaking empire here in the 1900s. But what you're looking at is number 6 and number 7 blast furnace, which are more than just a national landmark along the Monongahela River. They're a part of an incredible tour that you and your family can experience. Located along the Rankin-Swissville area, a few miles from Pittsburgh, this site holds something for everyone. Now in this video, I'm just going to show you a different perspective from what you'll see whenever you do the guided tours. It was with permission that I was able to record this for you, as this is private property and this video is for educational and promotional use. It's not for commercial use. I ask that you please don't bring your own drone down here and try to fly over or do any photography or video on the property without permission. The people there are very nice and are more than accommodating, so check with them first. There are many different types of people who visit the Carrie site. The first is what I call the industrialist, and these are those who understand and appreciate the genius behind Andrew Carnegie and Henry Clay Frick and what it takes to take iron ore and coke and limestone and make a man-made volcano of liquid iron. The next group of people who enjoy this place are the history buffs, and they learn about the thousands of immigrants who, like my grandfather on my mom's side, who came from Ireland, came here and worked in this mill under unimaginable conditions. It's so interesting, the history lessons, everything, all the stuff that happened before the child labor laws. You'll even hear some ghost stories. Okay, so the history buffs, you're gonna love this place. Next are the botanists, and they see the story of how nature took over. When this place closed in the early to mid 80s, nature always wins. And so it's really cool to see these buildings. Some of them had like trees growing on top. So nature always wins, and there's a lot of cool stories about that. Another group of people who like to come down are the artists, and they study the graffiti and just the beauty and industrial stuff. I'm not going to tell you there's something that you won't see in this video. You can't see it unless you take the tour, but the artist created something fantastic. Okay, that'll be a little surprise. Don't comment on it in the comments. You know it's there if you've ever taken this tour. It's really neat. Another group of people are the modelers, like me, who love trying to model steel on our train layouts, but now have a better understanding of how the railroads serve this facility and how to make your layout more prototypical. Now, what my footage doesn't show you is all the stuff that you're going to see inside the buildings. Okay, there is a bottle car. You get to wear the suit of the steel workers. There's even a caboose located inside the property. The guided tours allow you to see everything up close, and that includes the car dumper, which was built in 1926 and is the oldest existing car dumper in the world. At the end of this video, I'll put up a link to Rivers of Steel so you can schedule a tour yourself and find out all the other great stuff that they are doing. Now, one of the reasons why I'm making this video is because Walther's is re-releasing their steelmaking kits, like the blast furnace. And I thought before everyone goes out and buys the kits and don't know exactly how to put it on your layout and how to make it all work, come take the tour and ask questions and learn and take photos for reference for your layout. This is great. Now, right now, they're only releasing this in HO, but if we keep pressuring Walther's, maybe they'll re-release it in N-scale. So come to Pittsburgh. This tour, there are people that come from around the world to see this. There's not many places where you can actually tour a blast furnace and learn all about the history of it like this. This is impressive. You will actually, when you get done taking the tour, come back onto my video and leave a comment about how phenomenal it was. All right, that's my challenge. You'll love it and you'll thank me for it. And I thank you guys. I've done plenty other videos on steel making and about how to model it, so check those out too. If you are new to my channel, please hit that subscribe button and hit the bell notification to be notified of future videos. well over 160 videos of everything from life as an engineer in the past 20 plus years, to model railroading, to how to make your layout more realistic, and other cool stuff, even some silly comedy thrown in there. You can follow me on Twitter, Facebook, Instagram, my website djstrains.com, and I have a lot more videos coming. If you're in the area and you happen to see a CSX train, very good chance I could be on it, so make sure you wave. This eastbound train is on our main line. The tracks in the background is our P&W branch, which connects to both the Allegheny Valley Railroad and also connects to Norfolk Southern, so we can run Amtrak. Now, on the other side of the Monongahela River is the town of Homestead, and there is so much history over there. Also on, I believe it's 8th Avenue, is the Bost Building, which is the headquarters for the Rivers of Steel. So you got to stop in there because they have a tremendous displays in there also. Not much of the U.S. Steel Homestead Works. You do see a couple of those buildings, like the pretty blue ones over there. That's a little bit of what's left from the Homestead Works. But a lot of history with that area. And just out of view to the left is the Hot Metal Bridge, which used to connect both the Carrie Furnace side to the Homestead side. Alright, I'm going to let the music play, and I will see you guys in the next video. Thanks for watching.